couple of years ago, you could do a custom roster marker. Of course, I got rid of that. That's just shocking. Nice to get something for once. Come on. Skill boost. Fuck do I give a shit? To have more night owl events, but whatever. That's right, I need to go see if I can find those shoes. I thought I already tried to do that, but apparently not. I'm supposed to have free fucking shoes. I believe. This 2K just sucks, man. I don't understand what they were thinking. They fucked it all up. I honestly think NBA Live was a better game this year, as far as my career goes. It's crazy. Alright, Foot Locker. Talking about practice? Not a real game. Talking about practice. Give me some Nikes. I like the PlayStation logo. I think I just take them all, huh? Gotta have a pair of Force Ones, right? They should show him carrying like 50 boxes out now. Shut up, let me put on my shoes. Bitch. It's hard to pass those in Air Force Ones, right? Shit. The eye catchers. show me Anthony Davis warming up. Jesus, Harris, settle the fuck down, okay? Bullshit. What the hell? Wow, the hell, that was weird. Fucking buggy ass fucking game. Shot feels weird. It doesn't feel like Paul George. It's weird. Thought it would have reverted back. Fuck you, Ball. I'm so glad your piece of shit ass is off the team. Custom lineups, I fucking get rid of you right now. Get out of here. Wide open, top of the bar. Fucking Vince Carter's like all over my dick. Holy shit. Just all over me. Holy shit. Like, he was waiting at the half court right there. Like, he let people run by him. Didn't even get back on defense. Wow. Not covering me anymore, that's all that matters. It's garbage. I don't know why I just took fucking jumper with Rondo. Ah, Rondo's such a horrible fucking basketball player. Oh, maybe he has a jumper nowadays, but Jesus.
something to talk about.
Jesus. 50,000 call for balls just to get a shot up. That was weird. Just threw me off of him. Jesus. Alright, now we should be able to get our assists. JaVale McGee. I like being able to take control of the team, really, because you can just force the pace real quick. Great shot. Should have been green, but okay. I'm above 60%, so I'm gonna start missing. Fucking bullshit. But you can't help it. Oh, I lost my takeover. I purposely was let off. Bing. Oh, and it didn't let me shoot. I hate when it does that shit. Fuck it. I'm gonna start missing anyways. Might as well put it up. Get below 60% so I can make it again. I'm gonna get clip. That's a defensive breakdown? Okay. either pulls me beyond the 3-point line or passes it, so I step back and I'm way far away. It's like, holy crap. Just be consistent. Yeah, a little cheese does get you open every single time. It's just, God, I hate the consistency of the shots in this game. Anthony Davis on the team. But of course they're not going to do that. That's one of their selling points for 2K20. This is stupid. If I could call the defense and force him into his zone, force the pace, that'd be great. The only way to force the pace is to go run up on him. Otherwise, you have to deal with this kind of shit. Fuck it, he's still playing off. Fucking Vince Carter. Ah, you pulled me forward.
open. Just about every NBA game ever. Just passing to the big man in transition into the paint was money. Was slash is money. Give him some assists. Thanks. Kinda hurt. Fuck, hold me for it again. Who is it? Oh my god, you are the fucking worst passer ever, Hart. Holy shit. Thank you. Oh my god. How do you pull me from like half court all the way past the 3-point line? That's absurd. Did it again. Every single time. That was a 2. Just yanks me all the way forward. It's the first time in this. I don't understand. Nobody else seems to pull me past there. Thank you. At least I'm not having to call for ball as many times anymore. It's not fucking 10 call for balls per pass, so that's nice. Usually it's just 1 to 3. Ah, Jesus. There goes the takeover meter. Could have got one more takeover in. Oh, game. Oop. Badge of extreme R. Level up a badge. Oh. There's no purple version of the badges. game is such a step back in so many different ways. It's kind of crazy. No surprise. Same shit every time. Because they just put absolutely no effort into this 2K at all. None. There's no story after the prelude. There's no... You know, Shaq and them say the same fucking three things or whatever. They just didn't give a shit. They just kind of polished the fucking turd out and sent it. I'm so glad I didn't buy it for full price. Hell, I'd be pissed. $2 though, that's fine. I'd say that's about what it's worth. Giant step back for a franchise. I'm a little surprised that it didn't get tons of bad reviews. I mean, there's some bad reviews out there because, you know, obviously they fucked everything up. But they're like, oh, you bitch about my career. You want us to let you skip cutscenes? Well, here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna give you no story at all. Like, what? For real? That little China League shit was kind of interesting, honestly. I'd have been cool for staying in the China League and having a story for like 10 games or something, you know? Developing over there, getting a little better, and then slowly making your progression up. But of course not. It is what it is. Not much you can do about it. Not in the circle. This game, you get every single one straight, and then all of a sudden, top of the bar doesn't fucking matter. It's annoying. I miss the good old days when it was just skill-based. You hit the top of the bar, you're making it, period. It was green all day. Now it's a percentage base, like, really? It's so fucking stupid. Yeah, bitch. Nice little hand work now. Come on. After this game, my character will be a starter, and I'll have enough to get one more level on my 3-point. My 3-point's almost max for what I have for cap breaks. 60-something overall with max 3-point. Yay. Lack of phone messages, lack of, like, there's no, they're not keeping you engaged. I don't understand what their game plan is here. It doesn't make any fucking sense. You're not talking with the coaches. You have the same 3 interviews after games when you do good, but, like, other than that, like, nothing. You're not like engaging with the other players. You're not. There's no storyline whatsoever. There's no engaging with your agent back and forth. The endorsement deals are even like okay, whatever. You know, like it's really disappointing. Like I guess if all you care about is Park, fine. But God, if you care about story at all, this is like pathetic. Like I get it. Yes, the story was absolutely like mind-numbingly annoying last year, but you can't just completely get rid of it. You fucked up. Like to me, the gap between NBA Live and NBA 2K is like very small after this year, because I played both games. NBA Live had 10 times better story, and their gameplay is catching up quick. With the 2K basically making it less and less skill based and more luck based slash rating based. That gap is closing. It's gonna be interesting to see. My last game is a six man. Maybe there'll be some kind of story related to me becoming a starter. I doubt it. Cut defensive breakdown after blocking a shot. Wow, you suck. Like Rondo has absolutely no confidence in this game whatsoever. He'll come up, he'll pass 3-point line, and immediately chuck it to his left or right. It's like, really? Garbage. So I'm basically getting a pass from whoever the hell is in on the sides there, and it fucks me up a lot of times because I'm wide open when I cross the fucking half court every single time. Oh no. One of the rebounds. See? Every fucking time he passes it away, as I'm passing the fucking 3-point line. It's annoying. Just, I can't ground what's going on with you. Holy crap, everybody's fucking me over. Oh my goodness. Speed it up, that's all I care about. It's a great thing about previous 2Ks is being able to switch to a zone. Typically, a team would shoot quick because they'd be wide open. No. Oh my god, I couldn't make a pass from that fucking close? Like, I get it. My character is, like, completely fresh on every single skill except for three-point shooting, but fuck. For a fucking double team, you wasted my whole takeover. Jesus. Again, Rondo, every time up the fucking floor this game, you seem to pass it away. Immediately. Wow. Damn it. This is a horrible game. Ugh. Getting dragged beyond the 3-point line a lot. Got freaking. The point guards are just all of a sudden passing every time they get up there. Immediately. Good shot. Why can't you guys just pass me the ball? Like, why am I getting dragged that far forward all of a sudden? It hasn't happened any other game. What has changed? That's what I don't understand. Something's changed. It's weird. This is stupid. Like, this is game one again, all of a sudden. Having to call for ball 50 times because they're all just passing it the moment they pass the half court line. And then it usually whips me above the 3-point line. It's weird. Fucking A. I'm gonna go from a 90-some point game to a horrible game. It's like a last hurrah before they put me in the starting lineup. They're like, here, remember how bad it was not to be a starter. Damn it, quit dragging me forward. How was it two? Again, like I'm gonna have to take an even steeper angle sideways. I didn't have to wait for you to pass the ball sideways back and forth to each other. I wouldn't be having any issues. I wouldn't be getting dragged behind, around the 3-point line. I wouldn't be having any problems at all. For whatever reason, this game, you guys are passing it the moment you go across. And I have to deal with this kind of shit. This is not an NBA thing right here. People move. Even when they're burning clock, there's always somebody moving around trying to get open. But whatever. Again, really? Oh my god, this is so bad. Whatever. Oh my god. And then right there, I call for pass. I'm holding square to shoot immediately. Guess what happens? Nothing. That's the problem. Nothing. I just stood there. Holding square, my guy just stood there. It's so fucking weird how... Fuck this game up so bad. It's sad, really. It's just horrible. Whatever. Shouldn't get mad, because it's a $2 fucking game. But still, I'm mad. Oh yeah, takeover meter's gone, even though that was a good shot, but okay. Oh. I feel like they're taking too big of a gamble that they want that my team thing to get successful, because that seems to be what they're pushing, you know? Fuck story. Fuck a lot of shit. They're just trying to do the whole Madden Ultimate Team type of thing. I have no rebounding yet. It's not shocking. Oh, thank you. Thank you. Oh my god, it's horrible. What is going on this game? I don't care. Just hurry up. Let's go. We got a lot to make up for. Taking forever just to get... See, right here, I'll be open to the left. He passes again at the wrong time, and then I have to call for ball 50 times to get it. By then, my defender's going to come across the lane to get to that side. It's just insane, because it's never happened like this. But for whatever reason, Rondo and Lonzo, every time up court, pass the ball immediately, just like that. Every fucking time up court this game. Why, I don't know. Doesn't make any fucking sense. Will Ingram do the same thing? Probably. Yep, boom. Look, with me wide open. That's the crazy thing. Like, I'm coming across half court wide open like I always am. Like the last game where I just put up 90-some points. Coming off the bench. Fuck. It's crazy. I don't even know what to say. noticed they got rid of a ton of the badges too, which is another huge disappointment in my opinion. I don't know what they're thinking. It's just this whole game in general. I find more and more things I just don't understand what they're thinking. Like, they're basically taking apart their own. Look at that. He finally did a good pass. In momentum as I came across. He didn't pass it away to Junk. He actually did it right. It's crazy. Oh, shot blocked. I don't know why my guy's even inside, but whatever. Defensive breakdown my ass. What the fuck? Okay. Wide open, top of the bar, but okay. God forbid, I'm above 60% shooting, then you gotta deal with that bullshit.
What a game, what a game, what a game.
Wow. Just wow. Take your fucking time. Just pass it back and forth at the beginning every fucking time, you piece of shit motherfuckers. Because it makes a lot of fucking sense. Weird ass, stupid fucking mechanic. And the sad thing is they're going to do it every single fucking time because of whatever broken ass mechanics in this game this time. Not a single time has this happened except for this game. Look at that. Every single time they come up court and do it. Every fucking time. Explain it. Like, you know how you want to mix up a game? Make them do the same exact fucking thing every fucking time down court. Fuck. Fuck, fuck. Just drives me nuts. The amount of money that goes into... that this game makes. The 2K makes in general. Not only did they cut out the story, but basically everything seems garbage. Everything. Like, you, where'd the rest of the effort go? You know what I mean? Okay, you cut out the story. Got it. What else did you do then? Like, because I don't see it. The takeover bar? That's it? So is that the big new thing? That's it? Congrats. It's cute. Oh, God. Nice jump. Oh my God, I hate this game. I really just don't like the game at all. I feel like I'm wasting my time. Like, well, I'm leaving assignment because he's not going to shoot from fucking half court, game. Like, common sense. The amount of broken shit in this game. Just look at it. Oh my God, dude. I don't want to fucking play this game. This is so retarded. Every 2 seconds I'm finding something else that mechanically is just god-awful. I know. God forbid you try to throw a transition. Welcome to NBA 2K. We're just going to try to live off of our name. We don't have to make good games anymore. Nah. We don't have to have a story. We don't have to even have my player whatsoever. All you need to do is buy VC and hold square. That's our game plan. 2K Sports. Again, same exact mechanic all game long. They've done the same thing every fucking possession. Explain to me how that's a sports sim if they're doing the same thing every time down court. My team does the exact same set, goes to the exact same spaces, and the guy that's carrying the ball up does the same pass every single time up court. It makes no sense. Just wow. Well, let's wonder what's going to happen this time. Is Rondo going to go up the court and immediately pass over to the guy on the side there instead of me? Just had to bump into him. Fucking scrub. Go from 90 some point came to 60 because of this weird ass fucking set. And I don't know what's causing it. It's got to be something to do with the Blazers because I haven't seen it happen this season. Oh, that's why he's not passing immediately, because the game's over. That's the only reason he's giving me the ball all of a sudden. Because the game's over, so he's planning on just holding the ball. Jesus. I'll tell you one thing, I made the right... It just bolsters... what do I want to say? Reinsures the fact that I like to skip NBA 2Ks. Like, I play the fuck out of 2K when I have thousands of hours. And thousands of online games. Or my player games, my court, all that bullshit. Park, etc. But I typically skip a year, and this was the year I was skipping. I ended up getting NBA Live for like $20 because I was like, why not? It's back. Why not try it? It was pretty good, honestly. It made a lot of strides. It wasn't bad, let's put it that way. I didn't put thousands of hours into it, but. And then this is on sale for $2, so it was like you almost had to do it. And it's just disappointing. As a game overall, it's horribly disappointing. I don't know what they were thinking. It's the same fucking thing every time. They paid for like nothing in this game. No story, no reactions, nothing. What the fuck? You're about to be a starter. Joy. Yeah, your phone doesn't really go off. Nothing really is going on. Game after game after game, there's nothing going on here. There's nothing to say, hey, this is interactive and fun. It's just nothing. It's the main reason to play 2K, really. It's the main reason to buy 2K is the story and the, you know, the back and forth, the interactiveness. Yeah, it sucked when you couldn't skip cutscenes, but, like, overall, that's what you're paying for, is something that keeps you engaged. Yes, you're going to be a starter, blah, blah, blah. First cutscene in a while. Just because I'm going to be a starter. See, if they had more like this, it would be good. See, if you do this type of shit, it would be amusing. But they don't. Like, that's the first cutscene I've had since I ended the epilogue. 16 games or whatever the fuck I've done. It's stupid. Whatever. Badges seem easier to get, yet less of them. God, I have so many bad things in this game. Can't make the only grind the money grab. That was one of my prides on 2K18 was, you know, when the game came out, like, for months, I was one of the only people that had, like, all the purple badges and shit for my character. It was like, you know, a lot of people just didn't. They didn't take the time to get all the best badges. They just money bought. Badges seem to be a joke in this game. be a starter. Yippity-doo.
I'm gonna go take a piss, fill up my coffee, and watch the cutscene.